start in a few minutes, so just please final check the racket, make sure that the complex and the family.
Thank you.
also easier to try to do winter reports. That way there's just two people reporting. As a reminder, we are doing projection practice for the regular meetings now. So, if you get knocked out, you don't come to your home field, please keep staying here, because you'll be able to know that you're going to play more. And people will see the light. So, yeah. All right. I would like to listen to Hopscat. Really glad that we talked about your practice, the number you said. And Mr. Hopscat, and thanks again for coming.
We got Tito Tim versus Mr. F. We got Sharko versus, I think, Roman was the name? Roman playing the Luigi. Real name Jesse?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, I follow you on Twitter.
Nice.
I'm Clavicle.
Clavicle, yes. That's so nice to meet you.
Come to the garage?
The garage.
Yeah.
My kids are only being missing.
Oh. Oh, well, I mean, tomorrow. Yeah, like, it's Hershey area, but, like, Harrisburg.
So you're not too far away from Georgia.
I don't know. Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Alright. Last stop for this Luigi. I think it just... I don't know.
So, they might have just recruited someone.
Yeah, these are... thank
you for... It's still Sharko Roman round one.
I will let them stay up. Sharko Roman means Cypher.
Drew and Jake are supposed to play.
Someone just got a root from Australia.
Oh! Oh! it just comes down to nothing. And game one goes to Charco. I don't know if this is going to stay the way it is. It should be fine, right?
I think this match.
Yeah. Alright, Charco up game one. Probably banning, like, Dreamland. And Roman... looking at Stadium? I don't know about that counterpick. I think this is... Oh! The Marth switch? Okay, now I can kind of see it. I was not expecting that. It says Fox, but that is most definitely a Marth. I think he just wants to keep that extra space. Heavy use of death tag. Going for another misfire. Doesn't quite get there. It's a 1-8. Right. Seen a lot of like little piece hits. No big combos. Is that another misfire? I couldn't tell. Screen's kind of lagging. Sean, is there any way to... Is this just the capture card screwing up, or... okay. Yeah. It's just Jake and Drew have to play. Just keeping them away with those fares. Not really much Luigi can do about that besides just throw fireballs, try to get away. Goes for another misfire. I'm not a huge fan of these on stage side beats, but he's playing right now.
Oh yeah.
He's got the I think he thinks he's playing bracket though. Sharko with a healthy lead here. I don't think I've ever seen the Sharko Marth before, so this is a treat. He's trying to find his tipper spacing here. Catch him while he's coming down. This is a lot of percent. A lot of extra credit. And Roman finally gets through there. Got some work to do. This is not an easy comeback. Needs to play super, super careful. He's already taking a lot of percent. Forward smash after forward smash. Wait for it. Down tilt. That was actually so smart. And that does it. Charco takes it 2-0.
just looking.
Well, the screen's right here.
Hello? Hello! I don't know if we have chat. Who cares? We're on the mic. We're commentating. You know, theoretically, you could clip this, and then boom, you're good to go. No keyboard, though. The streamrunner's doing everything today. Unbelievable. This is obviously a very tight, very, very contested set so far. Just look at how it's 3 stocks to 3, and yet almost 3 minutes have gone by already. Very careful strat. Oh, that missile was so close. Sharko, how have you been? I didn't recognize you.
Just kind of zoned in the bracket right now, so I'm not feeling
anything.
Yeah.
Nice.
And I'm hoping you've been well too.
Yeah, I've been doing all right. I mean, it felt like the entire November, December time, we were constantly, somebody was sick, and then the rest of my family would get sick. Like, one of my kids would usually get sick first, and Jen and I would go, ugh. Then I got laid off in December before Christmas, and then still had enough to go to Genesis, and now I'm a stay-at-home dad. My wife has a job now, and I stay at home with the kids.
Oh, that's nice.
It's pretty cool. Yeah. Not always the role that you would immediately assume a father does, but I'm pretty good, content with it so far.
Yeah, it's nice that you can afford to be in that situation.
Finding out if we can afford it, basically. I got door dashing on deck if we are coming up short every month. So that's kind of the situation.
Nice.
Oh, Drew, can you report me too, since you had the bravery to do it?
Yeah. Where's the cloud?
Yeah, take it easy.
Falcon.
Oh, we're
We're not even
shooting like that. Just for the sake of recording, I like box. There. It's been said. It's been done.
Thank you.
Two. Two.
5. Last two stops. We gotta commentate this. This is too close. This is Drew on a reverse right now. If he pulls this off, we might have a new Quist in the building. Oh my. Down air. Oh, two down airs. Doesn't get a kill though. Oh, this is gonna get real nervous real quick. Oh, the shield. Back throw. Gets the up air, and that's gonna close it out. Your girlfriend trying to finish off this stock quickly. It's the grab. What can he do with it? Oh, he tries to go for a force smash. Getting a little nervous. Oh, no. Oh. All this percent is really good for kill kills. Back air. Off stage. Oh, he just holds the ledge. Damn. Four. Thank you.
2?
Yeah. Yeah, this is game 2. Can we update this?
On the first
no, I don't
one.
Think so.
Really?
Very
there
nice up tilt from Whiplash. Flaps giving them some forward airs, kicking them a little bit. Keeping the laser pressure on.
Well, I've definitely taken advantage of the zoning of Marth there.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, and that's.
Oh! Whiplash makes it back. He says, I'm not done yet. Don't count me out. That might be. Yeah, that's it. Doesn't matter. He comes back from these. Marth always comes back.
Can he space himself out, taking a breath? He's got a lot to work with here.
Nothing but time. Still keeping those lasers on. Make effective use of those.
Nice catch on the third.
That was good. That was good spacing. As a fan of the tipper. That was very nuts. Nair's galore.
This is just. Oh my god, that was just some edge pressure right there. That was
kind of
wild.
Yeah. That was good. Game 3. 2 for Clav, 1. 2 for Clav, 0 for Clav.
Flash gun with the box this time.
I'd love to see it. Play Marth. Trying to catch him.
Flap just getting the flash and no time to breathe.
Yeah. Pressure. Nope.
And that's what you come to expect in the Spaceys matchup.
Yeah, it's gonna be fast.
You know, with Flap holding his own.
It's power shielding going on.
I don't think that's gonna do it.
No Firefox in the world is long enough.
Oh, and here comes the Clav. Yeah, here comes the Clav. He's just
classic.
Working. He's going to work.
I've seen
he's
this
9-5.
A million times before.
He's in overdrive.
Yep. Took 8% there, I think. It is a shame. I'm rooting for Whiplash on this one. Clav's my friend, but. You know, I like the underdog.
Unfortunately, I'm legally obligated not to root for a fox.
Legally obligated.
I fucking hate fox.
Yeah.
The Falco not being much better.
Which is surprising, because, you know, your whole up throw rest. Fox is kind of a POS sometimes.
I just can't stand the up throw up air.
Oh, yeah.
Can't do it.
That's annoying.
And the up smash. I just hate it. It covers everything.
That's a good point. Turns out, Fox is a great player. Oh,
Clab just making easy work. Yeah. Busting out the mop.
I'd like to see Whiplash come back from this, though. I think he's got it in him. He's got the heart. He has the commitment.
Gotta give him the Clab, which we've seen before. Definitely.
He's pillaring. Clab he's pillaring like it's nobody's
business. Clab just
closing
the door.
Clab is putting the Greeks to shame. Not looking great.
Gotta commend the effort from Whiplash, though. Not slowing down at all, but I think that might be it. Oh, Clav doesn't cover.
Yeah, Clav messes up the edge guard. I'd like to see that.
That's gonna be it, I think. Oh, he's back on. I didn't think it would go far enough.
Fox's recovery is too damn far. There's no business being as good as it is.
That's gonna do it.
Damn.
A swift
a shame. 3-0. A shame. But good job, Clav.
Scared of Marth, so you're like, oh, I got him.
My head's like, oh,
Yeah. I don't care what you want to do.
Friendship may potentially die here, Sean. But have they ever played in bracket for a chance to move on to what placing does this guarantee? You can be top four to Drew or to Sharko Barko. So let's go. This is where it heats up. This is where it gets real. This is where, oh, we're gonna do hand warmers, hand warmies. Yep, hand warmers on the stream setup, classic, classic. I have this same exact arm at my house. So that's exciting. Ugh, there's a snake over there. I feel like they have all the lame characters. I saw Sonic, I saw Snake.
I will defend this specific Snake because it's the best player in Central Pennsylvania. And sometimes, like, when he gets against the right character, he's, like, wave bouncing, like, doing all this crazy stuff. But, yeah, Banjo's lame. Banjo's that nerd that got bullied in school.
Yeah, Banjo, I remember seeing Hungrybox in particular. It was still three stocks on a countdown timer thing, you know, a timeout match situation.
Yeah,
it was one of the sets of all time.
It was certainly one of the sets of all time.
That's right. Are we not getting any game audio, or is it down here?
Maybe you turn it on there.
No, I don't mean that. I mean, is it being recorded? Because
oh, yeah.
I don't know, is it down there?
Yeah, it's down there.
Okay.
Yeah, I left the same settings from last week and it sounded pretty solid, so.
There we go.
Once I touch it, I'm like, okay, it's good. Never touching it again.
Well, until you update it and then you go, I wish I did not touch. Oh, this is the OG OBS as well. You haven't updated it.
Yeah, so.
It wouldn't run on the new version for whatever reason because the capture card's weird.
Ah.
So I found the 30-bit OBS.
Go back.
And it works. So I don't know why it works, but it works better. So
let's not question it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I don't want to jinx it. It's working. It's been working. So I'm like, yeah, it'll be fine. I could sit down here if you were interested. Oh, sorry.
Pull up a chair. Lend an ear.
Awesome. So we got Sharko Barko versus your girlfriend. These two play a good bit. They're kind of, I think it would be reasonable to say they're like practice partners. And I think
they're friends.
Yeah, they are friends. That is also true. That's what you call practice sponsor partners in real life.
IRL.
Yeah.
Will you be my practice partner, babe?
It is Valentine's Day soon, so it makes sense. But your girlfriend having a good start to this match. I know he has a good bit of experience playing against.
Nice back air. Sorry, yeah. Couldn't help myself.
No worries. But he plays against Fox a good bit because there's a good bit of Fox players here. He practices against table as well, so you know, and a good back air. Fall in your line then.
So what I'm seeing out of Drew so far is I'm seeing a certain amount of unwillingness to react to the down throws. So that's what I'm curious about. Will there be more reaction on the down throw tech chase, or is it going to be making the read? Because when you are a certain level player, you're not going to say to yourself, yeah, I have the mental capacity, stamina, and wherewithal to do tech chasing right now in an intense situation, because this is loser's quarters. And so you want to do really well, and so what I do a lot as a bad player is go back to worse habits. So I'm talking about playing D game F game because I say to myself, I would love to do something that's more technical and faster, but then I find myself doing the slower thing that I had done for longer. And with Sheik, I think the easy thing for a novice Sheik versus a professional Sheik is how willing you are to react as compared to making a read, because Sheik can be very good. We see J-Mook at the very top of the game being able to react to just about everything. I really like that sequence, though.
That's a really good point. It's a lot about like building your bottom level gameplay, because then once that's built, you'll be able to go in a tournament and play a lot better. Oh, I like the little idea he had with the needle confirm, but doesn't quite get much off of it.
Probably wanted to do a forward air, not a forward smash. I feel like that's almost always a forward air, but who knows? Maybe Drew really likes Sheik forward smash.
Some Sheik players I play definitely like the forward smash. I think CR Burgundy's a forward smasher.
You got a down smash, I'm sorry. Or do something fun. Do an up smash. But forward smash can be crouch canceled into like 60 or something for some characters. I mean, I crouch canceled a Sheik forward smash at least 40%. It was, I just thought to myself, this is dumb. This is such a bad forward smash.
I feel like I say that a lot when I'm playing against Sheik. This is dumb. Especially as a Fox player, I'm like, I get tech chase. Especially Zero Burgundy, another Sheik around your level, and that's in a region. He definitely knows his tech chases, and when it's on, and you're like, man, there's nothing I can do.
Oh, I like that, going off the stage to get the back air, keep holding the ledge. Because when Fox goes into Firefox, you really got to be willing to go out there and get him.
He's got to get him, dude. I agree.
Oh, I like the up tilt grab. That feels like a J-Mook special right there. So I see that Drew's taking a few things from the Mook.
And I like how he's got... Oh, I like that wave dash back. He's really kind of just playing to the fact he has the lead and isn't, like, really pushing himself too far. He's definitely, like, kind of just moving away from Sharko into kind of the perfect positions because Sharko keeps trying to push like that. Doesn't get the tech chase, though. Tries to go for the side B up smash. I like the idea a lot.
Yeah, there's certain percents where it works really well. Or just throw it out raw. That's what I do all the time.
Yeah.
All the time.
And, like, oh.
That's unfortunate, as they say. Drew goes up one game. On to game two.
I think we're seeing the switch. Sharko plays a lot of different characters and kind of messes around with a lot of different characters.
When I talked to Jay Bobison about this, he said Sharko has been character confused since the very beginning. So here's hoping. Oh, that's a hard counterpick, though.
Yeah.
You know, Fox should theoretically be a hard counterpick. Are you going to throw out the ICs, or are we not going to bother? That's the ultimate disrespect when Whiplash doesn't go back to the PC and make it Ice Climbers, because we're probably going back to Fox anyway.
Yeah. And, like, I definitely feel like Ice Climbers is like, oh, I mess around with Ice Climbers a little bit, and it's like, I feel like counterpicking randomly with Ice Climbers, but I will say, the first, or second IRL tournament I ever went to, I played Sharko's Ice Climbers, and I was like, yeah, he's actually, it's not too bad. Oh, I like crouch cancel. What's he gonna get off of it?
Not gonna be able to get a conversion. I'm sure wanted the forward smash or something. Oh, going for a little bit of a soul read with predicting a land on stage, but I feel like a lot of Sheiks know that the ledge is their friend. You do not want that landing lag on the up B. Nice, going for Nana in this situation makes sense. Simplify the game plan. You don't have to put yourself at risk to kill Nana in that spot.
Yeah.
Oh, but doesn't grab the ledge.
Yep, does not grab the ledge, and he dies for it. So, Sopo's getting a little bit of mileage. We'll see if he gets any extra credit. That was a good up smash, and it kills. Wow.
Just barely, but the Sour Spot up smash still has some KO potential on these lightweights, like Ice Climbers, like Jigglypuff. Able to walk through Blizzard. Ooh, getting aerial interrupted.
Oh, nice.
See, that's a nice handoff, just a nice little 1-2 handoff into a smash attack. Puts you in an edgeguard situation. Also, I like Sharko has an ability to know what he needs to do to properly edgeguard and grab ledge with ICs.
Yeah. You know what? Just because how I'm seeing these Ice Climbers act right now, I'll be right back.
Okay, now, the question is... Okay, there's the switch back to Sheik. That makes sense. Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Switch over right away. You got that smooth transition. Let's go.
Yeah.
So that'll be an up smash. Oh, misses the up smash. I don't know what you have to do to get an up smash. I feel like you have to wave dash forward up smash, but I don't know.
That sounds
I couldn't
right.
tell you. I just always feel like they bump forward into the character that gets down thrown.
Yeah, yeah. No, that sounds right. And like, the nice thing too is, oh, is that gonna kill? Oh, nice.
Oh, just wait for a sheet to come down, and Drew's probably not super happy about that, but is now on to the next stock. You have to just say, you know what, that was dumb. All right, let's keep playing.
Yeah, and now he's smacking around the
I thought for a second that Sharka was going to go for a Nana save there. There was a world.
There was a world, and now there's also
a little mini chain grab. Works at lower percents.
Yeah. This Soul Toe's doing pretty well. The Ice Covers overall are just really doing pretty well. Ice Covers are
pick, yeah.
Yeah.
On the Sheik.
Yeah.
It's tough. And even without wobbling.
And
oh, misses. Too high. Yeah.
Ice Climbers definitely seem like a character that'd be like hard to do without warming up too. So I don't know what Sharka was doing.
And up smash city, this is a fox we're watching here or what? That's two up smash KOs. Let's go, dude.
Your girlfriend's playing like a fox made up hard. And he's gonna needle a little bit. I think like there always comes a time where you're playing against Ice Climbers. There's always a time with Ice Climbers where you're just kind of like, yeah, I could probably just take a step back here and see what they can do. And a lot of times, there's not a lot they can really do.
Okay, but now you're beyond a lot of crouch cancels, so Drew going to be able to go in a little bit more confidently. Still has to watch out for these. Still has to watch out for these shield grabs, though, because there's one thing that Icy's love, among other characters, nearly everybody in the cast, shield grabbing.
Yeah.
What a blessing. There's no frame one move to worry about. I'm a shield grab.
I feel like there's definitely a defined tier of like characters that can get shield grab really well and characters that like can kind of do something against shield grabbing.
Kind of.
Oh.
And throw out that shine. Oh, that was a nice reverse forward smash. I don't want to say reverse because it wasn't a reverse hitbox, but just got Drew out in the other direction, forcing the Zelda switch as well. Oh, roll back and forth. And no, died as, so gonna have to waste invincibility in this crucial last stock situation. Trying to needle the damage back, and he's now off stage.
And like, Sharka's doing a really good job getting in and getting these like,
big
smash attacks like that.
Oh, still got a charge, oh no. Let's go, Sharka, but also Drew, come on. I want Drew to win, is that fair to say?
In that case, to make it even, I want Sharka to win. And sometimes it gets like a double up.
Whoa,
up smash.
That almost worked too. I like being biased towards everybody. That was a great up B by Sharka. I thought that was going to kill for a second too. A surprisingly strong KO option if you have a floaty enough matchup.
Just kind of spacing around. And the down smash.
And the down smash will do it because you're able to kind of like ASDI down slash crouch cancel Sheik's attacks and throw out the down smash. So that's 1-1, and I think we're keeping the same characters and taking it to Fountain, FOD.
I guess it's good I changed the characters on the slot then, because like, you said, we're seeing more of the Ice Climbers. I think he has a really good game plan. He's not really doing anything too crazy. I think he's approaching better than he was with the Fox, and he's just really also punishing like Drew's approaches as well.
I also feel like Drew knows a little less of how to approach Ice Climbers as well. I mean, you shouldn't necessarily be going... Oh, okay, I like that. You shouldn't necessarily be going in with down air as an approach move in general, since you can hit Sheik anyway, regardless of whether or not the down air is out, but... I mean, Icy's has a nice up air, but I don't know. I mean, that doesn't really make a net bad for Drew. Misses the ledge dash.
Yeah. Speaking of net bad, that is definitely a net bad for Drew to miss that.
Net down bad for sure.
Net down bad.
That's why I don't ledge dash. I don't want to have a broken heart. That sounds like something I'd miss all the time.
You can't break it, or you can't miss your ledge dashes if you just don't.
You just don't do them. That's exactly right. Mm-hmm. Oh, I love the sweet spot up smash attempt there. Oh, that gets it anyway. Oh, and for good measure. Oh, look, the Nana does have her own kill animation. I did not know that. I mean, you just normally see the player run away from the Nana while Popo's dying off stage.
Yeah. I was like seeing the difference in like how people approach against the Nana. Like, oh, are they off stage? Am I going to kill Nana first, or am I going to take care of like Popo? It really depends on the player a lot.
I also think it depends on how safely you think you can approach killing. It's sort of like a little mini doubles moment.
Can you
actually approach this person who's in a bad spot, or are you going to get hit by their teammate? So You have to be really careful, because if you're too close to Popo, then Sharko's back in your lap already.
Yeah.
And so, like, there, Drew pursued for a little bit, then wisely turns back around and says, all right, you're the real problem.
Yeah.
The Popo, I mean. Wait a second. Is Popo not the lead character when it's red-white? Is Nana the lead character?
I'm going to be 100% honest. I just kind of see the one
who's drawing. It kind of feels like... Oh, are you on the Popo is always the person in charge debate?
Yeah, for the sake of, like, people not really realizing. I'm just like, because I feel like I would be min-match. Or, like, maybe even, like, last game of the set, like, oh, that's not actually Nana, that's Popo. And, like, you know.
Well, for the 10 people who are watching this, in the comments, let us know. Are you rooting for the Popo always, or shall we say Nana is the lead in this instance? Let's go, Nana. Oh, gets a grab. That's a crucial situation here. Is Abel gonna... not the SDI on the forward smash. But I don't know what you're necessarily supposed to do, because up smash also had kill potential there. I don't know if it would have killed Sheik, but Drew was clearly DIing for up smash and got forward smash instead. So good mix-up by Sharko.
Yeah, and good grab by Sharko as well.
But not able to chain grab, even though that should have been possible to do there. Oh, there goes the up air. Oh, well, a sour spot, but then still gets the back air anyway. Mm-hmm. But Nana's still living. Sorry, Popo's still living.
Yeah. So
this is a pretty bad spot, because you're gonna give up damage. Oh, no! The handoff forward smash. Able to make it back, but won't be able to do that too many more times if DI'd improperly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was crazy by Sharko just doing that, because I would have had no idea.
Alright, there goes Popo. And here's Nana. The Sonat. Let's go, Nana!
Alright, Drew really needs to get rid of this Popo if he has any kind of shot in, like, getting this match. Because then, if he kills him, like, and he still has a lot of damage on him, that's going to be a fresh new Ice Climbers that he's going to have to deal with. So,
hopefully crash cancel, love and heaven, not going to be able to convert on that one. Okay, I like the shield stuff. I thought I was going to see a nair out of shield there, but it's all good. And able to get the kill. 90%, as they say, is not necessarily doable. This is a pretty big deficit, and you can already tell what the game plan for Drew is. Try to force separation. Okay, Popo, you could have done something cool there, but you did nothing. And there's the down smash to secure game 3 in favor of Sharko Barco. We're going to get a tag change here. Okay. Oh no. Conceding that Fox might be necessary here.
The necessary evil, if you would.
Yes. Oh, and this is going to be... We're playing on 1.03. Wispy's not going to be blowing today. Interesting. That seems slightly mean, taking away Wispy's ability to do something to affect the match.
Yeah. What has Wispy ever done to anyone?
Exactly. Only ruin the placing of thousands and thousands of Melee players.
Throughout history for about 20 years? A little more than 20, God.
Yeah, it's 21 years now. Melee's legal, Sean.
That's good to know. Melee itself can come to Jax after a tournament. How about that?
Yeah. I won't be going to Jax though tonight. I forgot my wallet.
that'll do it. That'll certainly do it. I have to take care of my cat, so...
Yay, kitten!
Yeah.
Yay!
He unfortunately does not have an ID to be checked at the front door of Jax. So, you know. But looking like a pretty decent performance from the Fox so far. Nothing too special, just kind of going off his really good normals. And that massive back air, though, is going to send him off stage. See if Sharko can capitalize. Doesn't quite get it, though.
It was tough when you can't punish landing lag. I don't know why Fox, of all people, has no landing lag on an up B, but landing lag on side B, I'll take it.
Yeah.
Would you rather have landing lag on the up B or on the side B?
Honestly, I think the side B goes so far, it kind of deserves more landing lag, in my opinion.
Yeah, if I could, I would choose to have landing lag on the up B. I would much prefer to have no landing lag on the side B. That'd be dummy busted.
Yeah.
You could go on the stage for free, essentially, because you can mix up between going short or going long. So Sakurai made the right choice, allegedly. I don't know. Down throw, up smash, let's go. Oh, that up air was so close.
We'll get it though.
But I think that because of the sheer power of Fox, you're getting a lot more icy separation in this game. It just throws out the forward smash a la Moki. Doesn't successfully edge guard.
I like seeing, like, and this is not a shot at Drew because he's a very solid player and he just gets better every time he plays. But I like when you see a Fox that's not quite warmed up yet and they try to do shine stuff and they just kind of like, and then jump, then jump. So it's just like very, very like buffered a little bit there. But it, I mean, he's getting the job done. Three stocks, only 30% against this two stock Icy's. Oh, that was a mean down smash though.
Not able to capitalize on the forced angle though of that up B. This is a tough situation for Icy's, and so what I like from Sharko is I'm seeing a little bit of a pace slowdown, trying not to go in 100% of the time, because I think Sharko's original plan was I will out-character Drew because Drew is playing a secondary. But is now taking it a little bit easier, letting Drew come to Sharko almost. That's what I'm seeing the difference of in the past 60 seconds. Is a little less aggression on Sharko's part and more conservatism, playing conservatively. Oh, that was not the side B of dreams, yeah. Not what you wanted.
That was the side B of screams right there. Mm. I thought it was a good fight
for it. And the Popo is not able to shield in time and it is gone. Well, all right, let's go, Nana. Oh, rolls forward. No, you hate to see it.
Got some big up smash.
Shout out to Hada, who always rolls forward.
What?
Oh, the charge! And now we have a potential game five here. Wait, whoa. Okay, never mind. I was like, I don't have those. Let's go, Drew.
Drew just being like, yeah, actually, I don't want a game five. I think Sharko got this. And then, fortunately, comes to the senses and comes back on stage.
Well, no. That was an intentional setup to wait out invincibility. I wasn't realizing that Drew was waiting out invincibility by running off the stage and then side being ledge cancel onto the platform. That was totally intentional.
Oh, my God. I didn't think about that. Is Drew secretly the best Fox in 717?
Might be the best Fox tonight. I mean, still in bracket.
That is true. I hope Drew goes Fox.
Oh, wait. Oh, goes direct. Oh, getting lots of Ice Climber separation here. Good grabbing. trying to prevent tethering. And it's still separating them. That's been the big difference here with this Fox, is seeing the amount of separation that Drew is getting. This is a big opportunity here. Doesn't get quite the move you want, but nope, is now back on the defensive. This is looking like a game five. Looked like a brief moment there where Sharko had an opportunity. This is really, you gotta cash in here.
Yep. Looks like he's getting some money out of the bank with that smash. Oh. Looks like he drops his wallet on the way here though.
Was that a grab attempt and also forward tilt? I want to say it was a forward tilt. Okay, there goes Popo, and yes. There goes Nana, and we had a game five. And now we're getting a counter pick out of Sharko, looks like.
What do you think we're going to see? Cap Falcon?
Yeah. No, I don't.
So... Captain Falcon is a character.
Oh, wait. Switch. Drew's staying as Fox. Show some respect to the secondary.
Oh, he is staying
Fox. Anyway, I hope that Drew is playing as the Blue Fox because of Bluey. That would be awesome. Shouts out to Bluey. Best kid show out there on the current market, you could say. The current active kid show.
I like every time I see, like, go on Twitter once in a while.
Damn.
Like, I just see, like, a random, like, dad that I follow. And
that would
just
be me.
Yeah, you or, like, other people. And it's just like, yo, I've been watching 17 hours of Bluey in these last few weeks. So I'm like, nice. It's a good show.
Except you haven't watched it yet, but that's okay. We can change that tonight. You and your kitten. Cats love Bluey, too. Uh-oh. All these short hop aerials.
He's gonna go.
It is a little intimidating when you aren't on top of your tech game when you see a Falcon doing that so much. Oh, almost had the nice read there. But you will live by the read and die by the read as Falcon. Oh, and a nice tech backwards. I love seeing Drew mix it up for how are we going to land now when we're in disadvantage. Are we going to land with the tech or are we going to land with just bouncing on the ground? Oh, a nice call out there by Sharko to go to the ledge.
Yeah. When I put Sharko...
Ooh, there's the up smash of our dreams.
Nice. When I put Sharko in the smash up, he would do that, like, moonwalk thing. And it always tripped me up, like, no matter where he was, even if he was on the other side of the stage.
Oh, nice standing laser. Let's go. Oh, and a nice up tilt. Oh, and a, not a nice movement into... Oh, I thought for sure that knee was going to connect. Way to get the shield out. Oh. I like this Falcon. You know what? I was doubtful, but now I'm seeing it. I'm believing it. I like some of these movement choices. Jumping with the short hop nair. Trying to drift away back air just to catch an aggressive fox. This is some great move choices, but oh no, tech for Drew.
He just goes straight.
That is unfortunate. Throw out the up smash. Up smash. Up smash. There it is. No! It is unfortunate that Drew missed the up smash there. I wanted it. We all wanted it.
Also misses.
Wait, hold on. You don't want it. You're rooting for Sharko. Oh, that move should be a better command grab than it is.
Yeah, it's a very, very sad thing.
7%. Holy crap. You can crouch cancel it at like 40.
And the up smash doesn't hit the way he wants to hit it, but it still kills nonetheless. So, good stuff. Players are definitely going down to the wire here. It's going to be a matter of if Drew can hit these.
Like the grab after seeing Sharko DI towards the mitts. Throw out the mitts.
There's that no
Firefox go burr.
Yeah.
Oh, almost got the sweet. Oh, it almost got the back air. Or was it going to be a reverse knee? If it was a reverse knee, I would have freaked out.
And I would have also screamed into the mic. And
yes.
Everyone wearing earbuds would have heard it.
Oh, what? That was a bit of a... Oh, but doesn't get punished for it either. These are two players throwing everything out onto the wall. What sticks? Will this up smash? No, I called it too. Oh, I missed the dash of the up smash.
Spot those in a row.
Well, it doesn't get punished despite the high damage. That should be a dead fox, but the fox lives. The evil empire does not live. So now Drew back on the, sorry, on tournament stock, excuse me. Oh, and this confident movement. I'm seeing Drew wanting to say, hey, make a bad decision. Oh, like that gets grabbed. Oh, I thought a shine was coming out.
Oh, he just lets him back though.
But we're looking for that up smash. Oh, no, it gets stomped instead. Trying to secure the ledge guard.
Oh, back air.
Oh, way to drift back to the ledge. Sharko.
I guess no ass smash. Channeling kitchen table right now.
Oh, wow. Oh. This drifting back is so crazy. But no, where's the up smash?
There we go.
Okay.
Yeah, that's going to take it out. Okay.
So 35, you obviously would like to be at zero. A Falcon Stomper knee is going to hurt like a mother. Oh, okay. All right. Way to get out of there when it started to not go super great. They're just looking for, each of them for, oh, these wave dash backwards is, oh, and there's the moment for Sharko.
Oh, wait.
That really nice up air into really two nice back airs.
Oh,
and Drew concedes.
Gosh.
Sharko going to move on in bracket.
That was crazy.
And a hug between your two competitors. Woo. Let's go. GG's. GG's.
That was just like, that was for course. I bet.
Let's go Melee. I'm still rooting for you, Drew. You're icing out your competition?
By making sure my cat.
Good. Sharko Barco versus Whiplash.
How long have the Icy's been a thing?
Well, that's part of... Okay. That's over.
Alright, we got Clav set. I mean, exciting one.
Yeah, John Sharko, he plays. He, like, instead of getting good with one character,
he just plays that. I mean,
He hit, like, a wall where, like, he'd, like, really have to, like, dig deep and, like, try and get better specifically.
Did he switch every game during your set?
No. Game one and two. No, game one, I took his Fox, and then he counterpicked to Icy's game two. I lost two, so he had 2-1 on me. And I switched to Fox, and I beat the Icy's twice, so it was two. No, I beat the Icy's once, so it was 2-2. And then he switched to Falcon. Yeah, he's got like, you know, for his level, he's got a Falco, a Fox, a Falcon, Icy's. His Sheik's not crap. His Puff's not crap. His Marth's not crap. Yeah. Most of his characters could be my Fox.
Yeah. I don't know. I think I'm going to make the big switch pretty soon here to Sheik. I think I have to. I can't, like, progress further with Puff. I got to go back and learn the basics. Because I can just, like, I, like, totally skip that playing Puff.
Yeah.
I mean, not that you don't need him, but, you don't need him.
It's a little different, yeah, for sure. Sheik has to do a lot of stuff, like, out of shield. She doesn't have really, like, any safe pressure.
Yeah.
She has, like, the same safe pressure that Puff does, like, really well-spaced aerials.
I think that's why I kind of liked her when I played her. She kind of reminded me of Puff, like, in the air a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't really want to be a spacey.
No.
Just because I hate spacey.
Dude, that's good opinion.
I can't become...
One of the biggest spacey haters is Puff.
Was that?
Plup hates spaces.
Oh, yeah.
If you watch his stream, he'll, like, be tech chasing a Falcon and be like, die! Stupid Fox, die! Bam!
I'm trying so hard to just take one set from Whiplash. Took one game off of him last time he played.
Yeah. He's a little bit better than me. So that's tough. I think he would be a lot better if he played more, like most people.
Yeah.
I really want to see Kenny eat Sean alive here, though. I want to see Kenny win. If Kenny wins from losers, I'm going to cry.
Had a big hurdle in the grands there, though.
I think he can do it, dude.
Was that 3-1 last time?
Yeah, I don't know. But he can do it.
Yeah, he definitely can.
He's got to want it. He's got to want it real bad. And he does. But if he actually expresses that, we'll see.
He's prone to getting a little spooked.
Yeah.
Spooked into making himself mess up. Silly mistakes.
Kenny? Yeah? Yeah? Yes? Wow.
They are both just right where they need to be all the time.
Yeah, spaces are so fast.
When one gets on a roll. Oh, man.
That's the real evil thing about spaces, is they have, like, true combos at low percents.
Yeah.
Like, you know, Sheik Puff. Well, Sheik Puff has, like, a little bit of stuff that goes into rest, but spaces just always have something. Dude, I was, like, crying when I left here. I love playing you. That was so fucking sick, dude. You're so sick. Alright, I'm okay with that. I love Sean, but Kenny's gotta do this.
Yeah.
I'm not even gonna fuck with it. Yeah. I like moved it and like it like lost balance and then I tried like adjusting it and then it just fell.
I don't think this is just an awful under.
Alright, pick one stable.
How am I holding this in here?
Yeah.
That might cause, gonna cause from the...
Do you have a hard trigger?
Huh?
Do you have a hard trigger?
Like
no spring?
Faster.
No, like do you have a trigger with no spring?
Yeah. My left.
You can't soft shield?
Oh, right.
You can't soft shield?
I think I both soft shield.
Alright.
One, it's not springless, it's just short.
You should take a spring out of a, trigger. Yeah. It makes power shielding really easy.
Is that how
the power
does it?
I have no idea. I can. With a hard trigger, I can power shield pretty consistently. I like brainless lasers. Like if someone's playing around me power shielding it, if they're that good, they'll be able to laser me, but power shielding a laser is not that hard.
Okay. I want to talk to Super Sensor about it.
Yeah.
I got that stage now, I'm kind of comfortable in my play, I can afford to do a little more burn, so maybe that'll be it. I'll just bring that
forward. Yeah. Really yeah, you're good. I was playing around jump cancel grab today.
Oh yeah?
Yeah. I do need to do that.
It's a good idea. As funny as it is to be like devil's advocate whenever Cable's trying to make the point, he had a point there.
Yeah. It's just like really, it's really important for specifically like chain grabbing. Mm-hmm.
You get to be like frame, you get to get there in time.
Yeah, it's way faster. Yes.
I love that.
Okay, that was a really good DI into shine. Go down there.
Says searching. I was like, I'm not gonna get in a voice trap. He's like, no, I'm just searching. I was like, okay. I like to play him. He teaches me some stuff. He gives some pointers. Obviously, I stand no chance. He just rolls me 5 games in a row, just hardest out. And I'm just like, all right, you can go play ranked. I'm gonna go sleep.
He doesn't let my Falcon leave the ground. I'll do anything. I'm like. It's almost like he knows I'm gonna be a jump squat. He's crazy.
No,
nice try.
Well, it's crazy because with my puff, he doesn't let me get off the ground.
Yeah.
He just does like the down air chain. I don't even know exactly what it is. But he just keeps me on.
Oh,
he
just like lays there and
starts
over there.
Yeah.
Really rising there.
That's just fucked up.
Ken's
running this. Yeah, no, Sean's playing well. Sean's doing some good stuff. Yeah, Kenny won 2-0.
Yeah, still potential stars. It's worth to see that.
Dude, I think Sean underseeded himself. I think he seeded me above him. Yeah.
I feel like I have a harder time playing you than him.
I was third, yeah. I think Kel was second. I think he's just trying to be humble, but...
Maybe he tried. Did you hear about the... Like, the way he's gonna do seating? People in groups?
Holy shit, he's seating a fair shine. He's going off right now.
So, like, group A would be, like, twisting teams. And say, like... The last group would be, like, me, Jake, and Simeon. And then he's just gonna... Instead of assigning seeds based on, I guess, rank, he's just gonna pick people from that. Seed them, just like random draw out of those groups who can seed higher. So it's like...
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so I explained that terribly, but...
No, I think I get it.
So it's like, even if you're a high seed, you won't play the exact same people every week.
That's pretty cool.
Like, Quist will be seed one. 1 week, you know, routine.
Yeah.
If they ever come.
And it's just not really a game at all.
Well.
Make them work so hard for it, they'll like give him an opening in the second half of the season. Or it'll be like, no, actually, I'm gonna backtrack a little too far.
I get that thing going ice sandwich too fast, my tummy hurts. I got 500 calories of bread and meat.
I bought a sandwich downstairs for $6.
There's
790 calories for a sandwich. I was like, bro.
Like cheese in it?
Yeah, I mean, there was
part of it.
Cheese and meat and flatbread.
Yeah. That's not a calorie.
I think cold cuts are also just like dummy high calories.
Yeah.
Well, I'm trying to slow it down a little bit.
Oh my god. Not too aggressive, not too risky.
1.5 when his pace is when he starts to slip up. He just, I mean, I know it's tough to keep the full pace the whole time,
but
if he can, I don't think anybody's beating him.
That's how I feel. Nice. He really presses the trigger. Honestly, I'd be surprised. That would shock me. That would shock me. I'd be surprised. I'd be like, oh my god, Sean did what?
When I was in high school, I was a control guard.
Oh my god.
I learned to air my ways. Also, I get like food controllers now, so.
Yeah, way more.
I have a beater in your backpack.
Yeah, like I literally said I pulled it out of my backpack and threw it.
In high school, I used to get so mad playing tennis that I would go to Five Below and buy like a kid's racket.
Yeah.
And so whenever I'd come off and lose, I would just smash into the ground. It was only $5 opposed to $2.50.
Yeah. It's wise, it's smart. It's smart.
but I saw a bowling video and I was like, I've not bowled in 10 years.
I hate bowling.
Why?
I don't know why.
You ever gone with, like, people you like?
Yeah, like, I've gone with family. I love my family, like, siblings and stuff. I've never gone and, like, been drinking. I wonder if it'd be different if I was,
I think I've only been a couple of times with, like, friends, and that was pretty fun, but... We're getting rained,
too. I hear a woman.
For
real?
Yeah.
Alright. I don't have a dollar on me.
I only have 20 otherwise.
Is it game one or overall?
Overall. Okay.
Alright.
If it resets, then I guess I'll just do all the grands.
High rollers here.
Yeah. Do I want to bet $1 or $20?
$1. $1. I'm unemployed.
Stage is gonna be.
Yeah.
It should have been the dollar bet.
Oh, you know what I've been thinking about? Like, you know how there's like fantasy football?
Yeah.
And you know how, like, on Twitter, when people like win and lose, you're like, oh, buy club stock, oh, buy like SUJ, whatever.
Yeah.
What if there's like a fantasy football league where you could like bet on people, but also, like, it's the thing where, like, there's this one crypto company that's giving like smashes around crypto, and it'd be like that, except like entirely fictitious. Just like bet on players, and their value, their net worth will go like up and down, or like their value as they win and lose.
That'd be weird.
And you could, like, you know, buy Plup, and then Plup wins like a super major, and then sell all your Plup and be like really rich.
Yeah, I think that would be good in like smaller groups, but I think if everyone had access to that, I think someone would run it somehow.
Yeah, I think it would also, like, I was thinking about it in the shower, like, top players would be like, oh fuck, there's a lot of pressure.
Oh, my stock is so high right now.
Someone put $100,000 on me.
Be
I'm dropping out of the
regular, but just like Twitch channel points, but just like
for like top 100.
Yeah.
And you can like predict like, oh, I'll call this player moves up this many spots, or like basketball. Like, you can call like who takes first stock or whatever.
Yeah.
Like sport, like real proper sports betting for Melee.
Alright. Kenny can't get shield grabbed. Come on, it's gotta be stock.
Someone's gotta be the stock. Eventually, I think.
Specifically for the strong hit, that's...
Yeah. Got a little mountain to climb, definitely not over by any means though.
It's good, it's good. Bad. Oh my god, doesn't roll in there.
Yes.
I don't think so. Okay. What are you looking for, Kenny? What are you looking for? He tries to dash back out of the Nair. The Nair just overextends.
This is stressing me out.
Yeah. Kenny going all the way in the corner. I respect that.
That was just game one. Jesus
sick. Really fucking sucks. Why near there? Run up all the way. Running shine is Falco. Held the power shield.
See how long you can hold on to the stuff.
Yeah, I think these aggressions.
4% off, not much of a discount.
Not beating his nares.
Not hurt. Not hurt. Okay.
He's definitely losing steam. He's gotta get a crushing victory. That fucking sucks. Yeah. Yeah, he's not shining out a shield. Yeah. Once he does get a shine, that's juicy. Nice. Gets the lead. Alright. He needs like a crushing victory here though. He needs to do some mental damage.
If he wins this game though, I think that'll set him up for the next one. Really have some momentum. What song do you think he's got on?
I don't know his taste of music that well.
MMA or rap?
Oh yeah, it's definitely rap.
Definitely got the ping pong playlist.
I bet he is Childish Gambino's camp. For summer camp.
I just started to realize I have to listen to a little bit more chill music when I listen to super intense stuff.
Yeah.
It just messes me up. Oh, there we go.
Carrying the momentum.
That's another thing Kenny does a lot. He rolls in after his tech. He gets caught a lot here. The other day, he was in
No.
Right in the garbage.
This, dude, this whole set determines the vibes at the garage tomorrow.
Determines the vibes for the car ride home.
Oh, man. If that's how you want it.
Yeah, I have a principle of zero. Pain.
Yeah, I got you.
Pain.
Yo, me, when you're here in the future, VOD reviewing like a good boy, this is for you.